Hi, I'm Millie. I am autistic and ADHD. And if you're new to this channel, I make videos about neurodiversity. So I just recently got back from a trip to Germany. And one of my special interests is just food, but also just like, I'm just always really interested in regional cuisines. So I was born in Germany, and every time I go back to where I'm from, in Hessen, specifically the Frankfurt Rhine-Main area, then I always just felt like I wanted to share with people what the regional food there is like, because there's some really neat, like, very local dishes. So, yeah, I went on this trip and recorded some of those things that I wanted to share with everybody. If you want to skip this intro, I put chapter markers at the bottom, so you can skip ahead to the actual trip. So in this video, just to learn some German, maybe some, maybe a French word as well, I'll put some terms on the screen. And whenever you see a word flash up, then you just know how to spell the German word. And whenever I put a word up, I'll put a link in the description as well to a link to some more information about, that particular food or whatever it is. So for this trip, we just stayed in Bruchkabel. It's where my Oma lives, and that's on the outskirts of Frankfurt. And that's it's called the Rhine-Main area. So those are the Rhine and Main rivers. And any Germans watching, or anybody else who's been to Germany a lot, let me know if I get anything wrong in the comments, or please suggest if there's foods I haven't tried. I've been eating a lot of the same things since I was a kid that I love and are nostalgic to me. But if there's anything local to that area I should really try, let me know. I love always trying new food things. We started by going to a market in Bruchkabel, and I unfortunately got sick early on in this trip. And then I was trying out these new microphones and everything, new video equipment. So I was kind of focused on that. And my mom was amazing. She's really good on camera, so I filmed her. You'll see her in a lot of these shots, explaining things, and she did an amazing job. Like one take for every shot, I think.
Hey, so here we are in my hometown of Bruchkabel. Fridays there is a weekly market. It's like a farmer's market. They call it a weekly market. And there are some things I like to buy, and now we're going to go to Frau Keim, and I'm going to buy some cheese, my favorite cheese. It translates as hand cheese, which sounds gross, but it's called hand cheese because when it's made traditionally, it was kind of formed in a hand. But now, it's just a traditional cheese for my region that I really like. So here we are at the cheese vendors. So, was ich gern hätte natürlich ist Handkäse. Fünf Stück Handkäse. Ja, mit Kümmel. So I'm buying five pieces. You buy the cheese individual and you put some Kümmel. Millie will look up. I'm drawing a blank, but it's in English. Millie will look it up and add text.
So when we got the Handkäse, I was so focused on filming, I didn't notice my mom explaining about putting Kümmel on, and we talk later about how that's actually, I didn't think about the word in my head, because that's actually caraway, which in terms of sensory things, I mostly have issues with texture, but in terms of flavor, I'm a little more open to things. Caraway is specifically one of those things. My whole life, I've never been able to stand, like, to me, that's one of the most horrible flavors, but, and that's tough in Germany. There's Kümmel, caraway on a lot of things, especially in breads and that kind of thing. But I like the Handkäse without it. We also didn't show, I want to show the Handkäse in a bar sometime, because you can get it. It's called mit Musik, which means with music. And the story, that's how it's been explained to me, is like, you get it, it's with kind of oil and like the main thing is it's like chopped fresh white onions on the cheese and then a bit of oil. And what I was told, the story is like that the onions cause gas, and that's the music of the Mettmusik. So I don't know. Yeah, let me know if that's the real origin story or not, but that's what I've been told.
Put it on top?
Yeah.
Hessian specialty. Und Blutwurst, ein Stückchen.
Die Hälfte.
Und was ist denn das andere, die größere Blut?
Das ist so eine Thüringer Art.
Ach, nehme ich das Stückchen.
Ja,
nehmen wir mal. Die zwei.
So then we went to the seafood stand, and I just noticed outside there is a baby stroller. And one thing you wouldn't see a lot here is, I walked up to the stroller, and I was surprised because there was actually a baby in it, and which makes sense. But just like here in Canada, you wouldn't often see, you know, like a stroller like that, just unintended with a baby inside. But, you know, my understanding in Germany, it's like really important. I don't know. It's just, that's just normalized and it's safe. And I love that. So yeah, we went to this seafood stand next, and they had a really nice local fish. I mean, in terms of, this is more like southern central Germany, but the fish then comes from the North Sea, and the Baltic Sea as well. So that's where a lot of the fish are coming from. And then they had a gorgeous little vegetable stand, local vegetables and fruits, and some fantastic mushrooms, and lots of local flowers. Like, flowers are really inexpensive there compared to here as well. This isn't specifically regional to Frankfurt, but my mom loves this, and it was the time of year for it. It's called Federweißer, which translates to feather white. So it's white grapes, wine grapes, that are going to be turned into wine. And Germany has just amazing white wine, some of my favorite. And so this is kind of the getting into the winemaking season. So this is just the really fresh wine, like at the beginning of fermentation. So it's almost like grape juice with a bit of fizz from the fermentation process, from the gas. And so it just has this like light fizzy, a bit sweet, and less alcohol. This is similar to, people might know, Nouveau wines from France. So Beaujolais Nouveau, for instance, from France, and that's a similar idea. But those ones I've had are usually red wine. So this is a fresh white wine.
So here we have a typical German breakfast, or a special typical German breakfast. The most important ingredient are the fresh buns, which I got from the local bakery this morning. You have some with grains on it, and these, they're kind of crusty white buns called Lothringer. And then Germans are heavy on protein for breakfast. Of course, they're sweets. They're jams, which my mom made with figs, plums, and also, no, these are figs, the plums, and strawberry. And then there is some salmon, some local cheeses, and of course, pork. Pork always reigns important for about 3 meals a day in Germany. Another favorite are soft-boiled eggs. So that's a German breakfast, either with coffee or tea. That is something we like to enjoy when we visit my mom, Millie's grandma. It's kind of a one of the bigger meals of the day for me. And I always look forward to when I come to Germany to get the fresh buns in the morning. They have to be fresh. You have to get them in the morning. You can't eat buns that you got the day before. So today we're getting one of the family's favorite treats, Köhler Küsse. We are in the town of Hainburg, which incidentally is on the River Main, where I was born, in this town. And the factory Köhler has been here for as long as I can remember. And they sell a sweet called Köhler Küsse, which is like an egg white, a marshmallow type egg white cream covered with with dark chocolate or milk chocolate on a wafer, and it comes in different flavors. The traditional is just kind of a vanilla flavor, but you can also get it like a mocha flavor or with sprinkles on top and all kinds of different flavors now. So we're going to get a couple of cases now. And this actually used to be called kind of a racial slur. That I won't repeat. It was a traditional name in Germany before people learned that it was a racially inappropriate term to use. What is kind of weird that the name still contains one of the words of the old name, Küsse. Now they call it Köhler Küsse. And yeah, so let's go inside. There are always people lining up here, and we'll pick up some boxes of mocha and one of the traditional, and maybe some with sprinkles. Ja. Und eine mit Kokos und so gemischt, ja. Ja, gut. Das wär's dann.
8,35 wären's bitte.
So these are the ones we always get. The traditional ones and the ones with Kokos flavor. And these boxes are really interesting. These are seconds. You can buy a box of 100 really cheaply, but you don't know what flavor is in it. So it's really exciting. Mmm, yummy. Mocha. Mmm. So, das ist meine Mutti. Die Veronika sagt Hallo.
Hallo.
Und das ist also Millis Oma, ist Millis Grandma. And my mom, Veronika, is with us. And we are at Eiscafé Maintor. It's a place we always go to when we go to Germany in the beautiful city of Seligenstadt. We are down by the river Main, which is the river I was born near. And behind us, we'll later take a look at a beautiful monastery. But right now, the important part. We are waiting for Spaghettieis. Yes, Spaghettieis. Details to follow. This is something that's very unique to Germany. It is called a Spaghettieis. And don't be afraid. It's vegetarian. It is basically you take whipping cream on the bottom, and then you press vanilla ice cream through a device that you'd normally use to make pasta with to get the shape. Then you put strawberry sauce on top and some white chocolate sprinkles. So that all amounts to spaghetti ice. Mm. Delicious.
One of my favorite local spots to go for dinner that I was showing here is Klein's Brauhaus, and that's in Seligenstadt, which is just next to Bruchkribel pretty much. And yeah, so it's basically like all there is all over Germany, these local breweries, so brewery and restaurant. So that you can see there, they have the outdoor area. So that's just a classic Biergarten. So yeah, just beer garden, like it sounds. And for drinks they're having, because I wasn't able to drink alcohol on this trip, so I had lots of Apfelschorle. So that's apple juice and sparkling water. So it's a nice, really refreshing drink. I don't normally drink apple juice, but when I'm in Germany, I drink so much, whether in the alcoholic format or not. It's just so good there somehow. And yeah, and then we had a couple dark beers. So that's Dunkles beer, Dunkel beers, dark. And my mom was having Apfelwein because that's her favorite. And then for my schnitzel, I do love having schnitzel. I'd never had this one before. This was really interesting. It was almost like, I wish I could remember how it was described exactly on the menu, but yeah, so it was like crusted in seeds, essentially. So it had almost like a little bit of a crunchy exterior. And then the meat, like the thinly pounded and fried meat in the center. And with this dark beer gravy on it. It was super, super good. And I'd never had that one before.
A German tradition is Kaffee und Kuchen, coffee and cake. Now, you don't have your cake as a dessert after lunch or after dinner, but rather you go mid-afternoon. Most Germans have their big meal traditionally in the middle of the day, around 12:31, and then by about 2:30, 3 o'clock, you'd go to a beautiful cafe or a conditorei, like a patisserie in French, and you pick a beautiful piece of cake, like here. We have this mandarin, kind of a cream, not a cream cheese, it's sort of more whipped cream based, layered torte, and you have it with coffee. Now you can see that culture is kind of mixing and blending, because obviously this is not a traditional German coffee, this is a cappuccino. So enjoy, Kaffee und Kuchen. So here we are in the city of Frankfurt, which is really close to the small town where I grew up. And behind me is the Kleinmarkthalle, the little market hall, which is really one of the foodie places to go to in Frankfurt. There is a great selection of local dishes to eat, like you can get the famous Frankfurter grüne Soße, Frankfurt green sauce, which is a herb sauce you get more in spring, and then of course all kinds of sausages and pork products and schnitzel, and there's a fair bit of international cuisine as well. So in addition to that, there are some really good delis with local specialties, but also Italian, of course there are vegetables and fruits you can get. But Millie and I, we are here today to have lunch, and there is a lady who's famous for her sausage sandwich, so that is probably what we are going to try. Another thing I want to point out, to drink in Frankfurt, you can have wine, you can have beer, but traditionally you would drink apple wine, which is like our local type of a cider and something I really love, so I might have a glass of that.
So the sausage stall is very famous in the market there, and you just pay by weight. It's very simple, it's literally just a few kinds of sausages, and the owner's Frau Schreiber, so the name up top there is Schreiber. And we just got a classic Fleischwurst, which is, again, a real simple name. Fleischwurst translates to just meat sausage, so very generic, but super tasty, with some mustard and salt pickles. So salt pickles or something get more in a place like that. A few shots of us eating it outside the Kleinmarkthalle.
Okay, this is one of those food things that people might find. I didn't grow up here. I love this, but people might find this a bit horrifying. But it was like a nice little snack. It was amazing, the quality of food you can get for so cheap. It's got this bun. I'll show it in just a sec. But it's costs like €1.50, and so you just go to the butcher shop. And you get, it's called Mettwurst, and it's just chopped up, ground, it's like raw pork, so I know that's like something people are not used to. Raw pork and onions and salt and pepper, I think that's pretty much it. And I don't know, to me that's like really delicious little snack, but I know people might find that weird, but I think it's worth trying if you're up for that. Trying something like that, but yeah, to me it's good.
I wish I didn't get a good shot of it, but I'll try to show it next time. Just does not look appetizing, but it tastes good. If you've seen steak tartare, it kind of looks like that, just lighter colored because it's pork instead of beef. We then visited Walther to get apple wine, and this just shows how locally you can get things made there, right? This is a small town, about 30,000 people, and that's made there. We're showing the store, but all the apples are being processed into the apple wine, Apfelwein, right there, and that's maybe a kilometer from where my Oma lives. And that's just a beloved thing of that region that you get in every bar, and there's festivals related to it, and a lot of different producers there. So it's alcoholic apple juice, but people would think of as cider here, but it's different from the cider I have here, I think of cider here, and it's usually bubbly. It's usually sparkling. And I think a bit more full-bodied and sweet. So, like, I think of Apfelwein, it's definitely, it's not sparkling and much more dry and tart. And, yeah, like, less full-bodied somehow, but in a nice way. So it makes it really refreshing. And you can just drink it straight or mix it half and half with sparkling water as well. Just like my mom, that's one of my favorite things as well. Because we are there in season for this, again, like the wine, and also with the apples, you know, they're just starting to make the Apfelwein. So you can get some juice that's going to be turned into wine, but it's just at the beginning of the fermenting process, and that's called Rauscher. So that's what we have in this bottle. You know, it's just a bottle that they fill up. It's not a labeled product or anything, but it's in the fermenting process, so you have to leave the cap off loosely so the bottle doesn't explode. But that's another really tasty thing, you know, like, again, slightly fizzy, and but just with that nice fresh pressed apple juice flavor. This was dinner at my oma's, and I think this is a very traditional Sunday dinner, Rinderrouladen. It's very thinly sliced beef so that you can wrap it up, and then it's wrapped around bacon and onions and mustard, and then cooked in a gravy. And then we had that with Semmelknödel, which are bread dumplings, and they're delicious as well, and Rotkohl, which is one of my favorites. It's traditional with Rinderrouladen, which is a sweet and sour red cabbage. If you haven't had it, like, obviously a lot of people know sauerkraut here, but sauerkraut is, you know, really just sour. But this has that nice sweetness to go along with the sour to balance it out a little bit. So this here, we had some currywurst. This was just when we were waiting to check in to our hotel at Fantasialand. We just had a classical Berlin-style currywurst. It's a regular sausage and then tomato ketchup with curry spices in it. That's really delicious. It's one of my favorite snacks of all time, like classic street food that you'd find in Berlin.
So here we are at the Schlachtfest in Bruckköbel. Schlachtfest literally translates into a butcher fest. It's not a party for butchers, but it's something farmers would have traditionally done whenever in the fall or before Christmas, when they would butcher an animal like a pig, they would invite their neighbors and have a party. So here we have some traditional products, like we have pork belly, and we have liver and blood sausage with sauerkraut, and a sausage with sauerkraut. And I opted for something less traditional, which is a squash soup, the vegetarian option. So even the butcher festival in Germany now has a vegetarian option. Drinking, we have traditional apple wine or freshly pressed apple juice as well. There's always beer. Enjoy.
And this is the last day of the trip. We were catching the train to the airport, and this is just a local station that we go to when we're heading back out of the country. And just like almost every other train station in the area, there's this chain of bakeries called Wiener Feinbäcker. And I just wanted to show that in there as, like, it's, you know, it's a chain, and, you know, as far as I know, all those things are baked at a central facility, but they're still freshly brought in on the day. And it just shows that even in a little, slightly grimy train station from a bakery chain, you can still get fantastic bread and a lot better bread than I can find in Canada, at least like that style of German bread. Thanks for joining me and my mom on our mini regional tour of food in the Frankfurt Rhine-Main area. And as I said, regional cuisines are a special interest of mine. So thanks for taking the time so I could share one of my special interests with you. And I hope to go back to Germany. I mean, I'll always be going back to Germany, but I want to do another one about local foods, but in the springtime, because there's a lot of other things that you can get mainly in the spring, like my favorite, which is Frankfurter Grüne Soße. So I'll have to show that more in another video. And please subscribe to this channel if you want to see more about, again, my visit to Fantasialand on this trip, and just generally more content about autism and neurodiversity. Thank you for watching.